Greetings from the foothills of Alberta, where we will conclude week 9 of the Canadian Premier League. Nigel Reid in the booth alongside former Canadian international Terry Dunfield as Cavalry gets set to host expansion team Vancouver FC at Spruce Meadows in Calgary. Tommy Wilder makes 3 changes from the team held by Forge last weekend. In at fullback, Roberto Alarcon. Into midfield, Charlie Trafford and Gauthier Tigny, the young attacker. The third of the changes. VFC, Vancouver FC, well, you might say they might have been tempted to make a whole bunch of changes after what happened last week. But Afshin Gotbi has been there too many times to panic. Just one change to the team that took a bit of a shellacking last weekend.
Before coming to Vancouver, he's had 8 games now, so he should be getting caught up to speed here. Create something out of nothing, score. Feel like there's goals in Hundo.
Chandler doing what is necessary, and they've got the opener. And Sean Hundo from Sandoval inside 4 minutes. It was a real mess at the back from the Cavs. And Vancouver FC strike first at Spruce Meadows. Vancouver lead by a goal to nil.
Interesting today, this week in the media, he came out and said that he should go and win the Golden Boot this year.
Tahir, goodness me. The teenager decided to have a pop from 20 yards and needed a firm glove from Marco Carducci.
Why not?
Tigny used his body well to protect the football. Down top. From Bevan. One-on-one with the goalkeeper. No panic. Coolest finish you could wish to see. And we've got 2 goals inside the first 10 minutes. And Cavalry have drawn level with Vancouver. It's 1-1. Cavalry throw level with the edge of the penalty area. 2 early goals in the welfare contest. Alarcon. All the way across goal, too close to Callum Irving, whose handling was self and secure. Gauthier Tigny, 21 years of age. Good run. Oh, he's in here, one-on-one. Decides to pass. Bevan, 2-1. It's a brace for Bevan. Deceptively simple. Defenders will pull all over the place. And a second critical finish in the space of 15 minutes from the Kiwi Maya Bevan. And Cavalry have come from behind to lead Vancouver FC by 2-1.
What are we doing, Doughty and Cavalry? They slice and dice Vancouver. Yeah, it can be a little tricky to change your tactics on the fly. I think for Vancouver now, it's just get to half time.
Plenty of room on that far side. 3 to aim for in the box. Oh, but it's gone in, has it? It has gone in. And Sergio Camargo got the last touch. 27 minutes gone. It looked as though a dangerous pass, but nobody picked up. It is Sergio Camargo. The foot soldiers celebrate again. And Cavalry lead Vancouver by 3-1.
Yeah, it all starts with a great diet from Cogza. Then we see that right-hand side overloading Vancouver. What a nice run from Bevan to the near post. Just helps it on off the crossbar.
We're in no hurry to give the ball back. Camargo spreads it for Alarcon on that far side. Moussi and Bevan into the area. And Tigny as well at the back post. Of course it comes.
I thought it was Vancouver's best sequence. Beautiful football across the pitch, and I thought it was clever, the little cutback. Sandoval kind of just gave up on his run.
Bitar again towards the edge of the penalty area. Bitar likes to have a strike, does. Too high, didn't trouble Carducci, goal kick for Gabby Bitar. 5 goals for FC Edmonton in the CPL last season. Hobson takes over. Shima. At times it's almost like a practice match. It's towards the penalty area. Bevan trying to win it. Referee says it's okay, he won it cleanly. Moussi thought about it. Trafford to the edge of the penalty area. Alarcon towards the back post. And belted away by Bakary. And for a moment there was panic stations at the back for Vancouver. Escalante, the Honduran, from part of the Cavalry scene. Bevan appears to be onside here. And Beckford and Moussi are busting it up to get there. Bevan both behind Moussi. They'll come to Beckford. Had to take it first time. Couldn't keep it down. But you could see what he was trying to do.
Again, great movement from Bevan in behind.
And now makes his way towards the penalty area. Will the service arrive? Comp in the way. The youngster Cameron wins it again. Sandoval, there's room for Quark on this near side. Quark off the crossbar. Balducci was beaten, and that's as close as Vancouver FC have come to reducing the arrears. Minjay Quark, right-footed, and then drags the second attempt wide of the post.
Does really well, nice to create half a yard for himself. Nice football from Sandoval as well to just help the ball across the pitch here. Had a half chance moments earlier.
It was almost over as a contest by halftime, not quite, but Cavalry have been professional in the second half. And the referee has seen enough. David Barry blows his final whistle. Second win of the season for Cavalry. Maya Bevan, the star, with two goals and an assist and a big smile from the big Kiwi centre forward. Vancouver, the second best. Seven games without a win for the expansion team. They remain rooted to the foot of the CPL table.